Okay, so similar to what we did there in the previous video, let's go over the main types of calculation in COBOL. And notice you can initialize a variable in more than one way. COBOL was normally written in uppercase, so I'm going to try to stick to uppercase here. Here's our paragraph, right? So, similar to what we did before. We'll accept a value for A. And we'll accept a value for B. But we'll be more thorough this time. I want to show the four main arithmetic operators, right? I would say subtract B from A giving C. Right. A minus B equals C. I'll use the asterisk here. Divide A by B giving C, right. And also there was the compute statement, so you can do anything you want with the compute statement. So you could say C equals A plus times B plus 112 or 11 divided by 3. Plus 4 minus 1, right? See? It doesn't like that 4 minus 1, right? Because it needs spaces to distinguish it from the minus sign, right? And then we'll just accept a dummy value here to stop the computer so that you can see the display. Let's run this program. Okay, it says enter A. Start with the simplest possible example. A plus B equals 0, 0. Right? Okay, so there's something wrong there. Let's check the program to see what it is. We're accepting A, we're accepting B, we're adding A and B giving C, right? So let's, this is actually a good example of debugging a COBOL program. We need to see what's in A and B, right? Like this. What did we say? 0, 1, enter. 0, 1, enter. A equals 1. Well, I must have somehow hit the wrong key there. Maybe I didn't hit the enter key the first time, or I did something funny. Because now it's working. Okay, A equals 1, B equals 1, A plus B equals 2, A minus B equals 0, A times B equals 1, and A divided by B equals 1. Right, and the computed value is 7. Okay, that's good. Right, now let's try it with some bigger values, right? 11 and 0, 9. Okay. 20, 2, 99, and 1. Okay. But what if See, you see here, C is two digits. What if the result was more than two digits? What would happen, right? What if I put 99 in here and 88 in here, right? You see it just rolls around, right? The answer is actually 187, but it just loses the digit there. That'll depend on the machine, right? Because when I was working on the IBM mainframe, the program would blow up. We would say bomb, right? 99 minus 88 is 11. 99 times 88, see again, that's the answer is not 12, but it's losing the digits. And A divided by B, like 99 divided by 88 is not 1, right? But it's it's losing the fractional part. Okay, what if you did a divide by 0, what would happen? This will be interesting, because I want to see what the answer is myself. Okay, it just sets it to 0. Again, if it was an IBM mainframe, it would bomb out. If the answer was 0, it would bomb out on an IBM mainframe. So therefore, before you do any division on an IBM mainframe, you should always check to make sure that the denominator is not 0, right? So you would do something like this. If B is not equal to 0, then divide A by B, giving C, right? Else, move 0 to C, right? That's how you make sure that you don't get a divide by 0 error in IBM mainframe COBOL. So 1, 1, enter, 4, 4, enter. There, so they're all working properly, I think. But okay, let's just fix that problem with the significant digits, right? Let's set C equal to 9999. V means an implied decimal point, right? So let's run it now. Okay, let's say 2, 2 and 1, 1. Okay, so 2, 2 plus 1, 1 equals 33. See, there's the implied decimal point. 11. 22 minus 11 is 11. 22 times 11 is 242. And 22 divided by 11 is 2. All right, let's try an example with a fractional part. So for example, 0, 4, and 0, 3. Okay, so 0, 4, 4 divided by 3 is 1.33. That's the implied decimal point. If you wanted to make this nicer, for example, if you were printing this on a report, then you could, the way it was done on a report is you would have a variable, let's call it D, pick 9999.99, like that, right? This is the display variable, right? This is the kind of variable you would use on a print line, right? And then you would say, move C to D, right? And then you would put the D here, right? So let's copy this line and do that with all of our displays. Move C to D, then display. That way, when we divide one number by another number, we'll be able to see what the result really is. By the way, another thing you could do in COBOL is you could put more than one command on the same line, like that. It's not considered good practice to do that because it makes it difficult to follow the program. But Grace Hopper originally, she had the idea that it would be, COBOL would be like English, so you would say something like this. So that it would look like a bunch of English text. She had that idea, right? Unfortunately, it might have sounded like a good idea at the time, but it turned out to be extremely difficult to follow what was happening. So it was never adopted by anyone in business, right? Unless you deliberately wanted to make the program impossible to understand, which some programmers do. Okay, so 1 divided by 2 is 0.5, right? And this computer thing is 8.66. Right? Let's try one more thing. Let's try running it. And we'll just put in one digit instead of two digits, right? So I'll put in a 4 and hit return. Put in a 6 and hit return. Okay, see, it's smart enough to realize that it's a 0.4 and 0.6. Some compilers are not smart enough to do that. Some compilers will blow up if you do that, right? So that's why I was entering like 0.4 and 0.6 normally. So that's our lesson in COBOL mathematical calculation, and thanks for watching.